I am looking at either Pelleve or Thermi to assist with the loss of collagen under my eyes. Which is best? I have had Thermi once and did not see a huge difference. I am aware that it takes 3 to 4 times to see significant results. However, at $300 a session, it is quite an expense. On the other hand, Pelleve offers similar results at a significantly less price at $95 a session. Can you tell me the difference between the two and advise on which provides the best result?
Thank you for your question. You submitted a question without a photo, and you stated in your question that you had a Thermi procedure and you didn't see a huge difference, but you understand it takes 3 to 4 sessions to see a difference. But at the same time, you've become aware, of course, that there was a cost difference between Thermi and Pelleve, and you want to know if these are the same technologies or what's the difference. Well, I can certainly give you some guidance into this type of concern and questions that people have. A little bit of background: I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years, and I have been part of this continuous evolution of thermal energy devices for the past 20-plus years, beginning with the original CO2 lasers back in the early to mid-90s. So you raise a very, very good question, and it certainly actually brings into focus a broader issue that I certainly have some opinion about. So to begin with, let's understand what Thermi and Pelleve are. They're both radio frequency technology devices that induce a certain amount of heat to create skin changes, what is essentially collagen remodeling. If you actually watch the procedures being demonstrated, they look exactly the same. And essentially, for all intents and purposes, they are the same. From a scientific perspective, they're both handheld devices that apply energy to the skin through radio frequency technology to generate heat to a target temperature. Because the science behind these devices essentially is the same from the way the heat is generated and the goal of the tissue response. You see, there's basically a core concept that when skin is heated up to a certain level, there is a response, the generation of something called heat shock proteins, and a process of collagen breakdown and remodeling that results in favorable response, such as the improvement of fine lines and wrinkles. Now, the challenge is for the consumer is that, unfortunately, there's a real race between companies to dominate and create a brand awareness rather than educating the public about what the science is and letting the physician be the person who actually guides you as to what any of these particular devices can do. From my perspective as a practicing doctor, these devices are tools, and the patient comes to me with a particular problem, and I don't have to be locked into just using one tool. I can use a combination of approaches. So in principle, you're looking at essentially similar devices doing similar things. But when I look at someone who wants improvement of wrinkles, let's say the under eye area, I don't just say, okay, there's only one device. But essentially, I will combine it with other modalities because typically there are a lot of things that can be improved at the same time. I always say the whole is greater than the sum of the parts. So it's not unusual to have issues with pigmentation, issues with the surface of the skin, issues with volume loss. So to solve those issues, we also include modalities such as the use of PRP, or platelet-rich plasma. Platelet-rich plasma is derived from your blood and is used to stimulate collagen and create this remodeling of skin without inducing using heat. You know, one of the things I should point out is although the skin can be heated to a certain temperature, the response of the skin is not consistent between people. It's like going to the gym. Everyone goes to the gym and may do exactly the same workout, but everyone will develop a different degree of muscle growth. The same thing with skin. Multiple factors, whether it's age, ethnicity, tissue type, just so many, too many factors to really articulate all together when you don't look at the whole global picture of the patient's medical background, their sun exposure history, their smoking history. There are a lot of things. So a lot of times people get really disappointed when they see a device that they see on television that's promoted aggressively and is the next miracle, and then they go and have these procedures and they don't get results. And a lot of times it's because there's basically a commoditization where in many situations the physician actually isn't involved in the planning of the whole procedure. The patient comes to a spa of some kind and a non-physician says, okay, well, this is the device that we use for that. What kind of package would you like? I look at things a little bit more globally. I look at the patients, as I said, I would consider using platelet-rich plasma. I use possibly a hyaluronic acid filler, such as a Restylane, to help with the tear trough area. I would use maybe a neurotoxin, like Botox, to help with fine lines and wrinkles. And I'd put into perspective for the patient the realistic potentially benefits of these devices. In our practice, we have Pelleve, and I should disclose that we have Pelleve. We don't have Thermi at this time. We also have 1064 YAG lasers, Q-switch lasers, fractional CO2 lasers, erbium lasers. We have a lot of technology. And so there's no limitation in providing solutions for our patients. But what we don't do, and what I don't do, is I don't just jump on whatever is new and exciting for that moment, because I've seen a lot of hype for devices, and really it's more about the devices and the manufacturer's interest in selling and leasing those devices to doctors, and then within another year or so selling or leasing a different version of device, making the previous device obsolete. So it creates this kind of tension between the patient, the consumer, and the physician. But remember, the physician is the one most qualified to give you guidance and give you a whole plan. At least I feel that's the role of a physician, and that's what I do in my practice. So even though there may be a price difference between the two devices coming from different potential practitioners, get a good understanding as to what kind of outcome you're looking for and what is realistic with either device, and also understand what your other options are. But as far as answering the question about the technology and the outcomes, these devices are, as far as I'm concerned, pretty much the same. And although manufacturers will always try to differentiate from one from another in ways that might be significant from a sales point of view, for a physician from a instrument point of view as a tool, I would say that it would be no difference for me which of these radio frequency devices I would use to accomplish a particular target heating goal to generate collagen. So I think you should actually, before you continue doing more packages or looking at more brands, either seek the attention of the physician you're going to for this device, or this treatment, or find a physician who can guide you and have a more global plan. Otherwise, you will be like many people, bouncing from one practitioner to another, reacting to these strong messaging for one miracle device to another. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.